some sort of class in learning Hindi.
今天早课我们在就说坐完凳子以后呢，有一些复训者在这学习印地语的发音和发音。So
I was on my computer just this minute, trying to look up a certain called gutturals as a certain pronunciation.
我就在电脑上查了一下关于一些发音的一些东西。
And just by chance, this is after you left the room. I came upon this devotee named Bhurijanda Das. Who he'd written a book about, he used to preach in China. I read a part of a book that was written by Bhurijanda. And I just thought it was amazing. Like I was suddenly, I found myself in China in a computer. And he was describing how he brought the very first Chinese devotees to Mayapur to meet Srila Prabhupada.
那么他当时呢就讲到了他如何带了第一批中国复兴人去见帕帕德在麻雅普。
And how they arrived in Calcutta airport and immigration would not let the Chinese
go in. 然后呢，他当时他们70年代可能是去加格达的机场的时候，那些人不让中国人进入境啊，印度的海关。
They'd forgotten to arrange visa.
因为他们没有做任何签证就跑了，坐飞机过去了。
So they said no, he can't come.
所以在海关的时候呢，那些人就挡住他们，不许进去。And
this is Bhurijan Prabhu. Actually, now my son lives with Bhurijan's son. Together, they live together in Mumbai.
现在他的儿子就跟这个Prabhu啊，Bhurijan Prabhu的儿子住在一起，在孟买。
So I just rang my son and told him, you know.
然后我就打电话给我儿子说。
Yeah,
but
it was very unusual, you know, like very unusual circumstances. So then Bhurijan Prabhu said to the customs official, you have to let him in. Look, he's adjusted your lifestyle. He's wearing dhoti, he's wearing kurta, he's wearing tilak. He's taken to Indian culture.
所以当时呢 ，Bhurijan Prabhu 就跟海关的官员就说了，说一定要让他们进去啊，通过这个海关，说他们现在穿 dhoti 啊，擦提拉克，就说接受那个奉爱的文化。
So they went. The customs official went off and they talked, you know, between amongst each other.
后来呢，这些海关的人哦，在那讨论呢，哦，就进行了一番讨论论证呢。And
the devotees they were praying to Mahaprabhu.
哦，那这些奉献者就跟Mahaprabhu祈祷。I'm
sure Prabhupada, please.
来跟Prabhupada祈祷。
And finally, the customs official said, okay, you can go, you can come in, but you have to give some money just in case anything goes wrong.
所以呢，那海关就答应他们，让他们进去了，就现场就签证的。然后呢，就说，但是要交抵押金吧，可能就说怕他们有什么别的活动啊，非法活动。So
then, Bhurijan, all he had was 200 rupees.
但是 Bhurijan Prabhu
的身上只有200卢比，然后呢，把这200卢比给了他们。And they said, "Oh, quickly, you can go."
然后呢，就让他们过了。I
was really excited. So then they traveled to Mayapur.
然后呢，他们从加格达就去了Mayapur。And
when Srila Prabhupada saw them, he was up in high in one building.
然后帕帕德当时呢见到他们的第一眼的时候，他是在楼上的。
And he was all with other GBCs and sannyasis.
跟那些 GBC 和 sannyasi 在一起，可能有开会或者讲一些话。And
he saw Bhurijan with these Chinese devotees.
然后呢，看到 Bhurijan Prabhu 跟那些一群奉献者，中国奉献者。And
he immediately called.
赶快跑，叫他们过来。And
then he came down and he was talking with them all.
然后呢，他就跟那些奉献者在交谈。And
there were many very high class aristocratic Calcutta people there.
那么当时呢，来自加尔各答的一些贵族啊，就是一些比较好的家庭的人，也在那里啊，跟帕帕德在那里。And
Prabhupada said, the communists are, what did he say? The communists are coming into Bengal and they're making everyone in Bengal communist.
但是帕帕德就说了，他说共产党进入孟加拉，让每个孟加拉都变成共产党了。孟加拉是唯一一个邦是有共产党统治的、职权的，现在也是共产党对。
Canada.
But he was very proud and he said that we are going into China and we are making the communist Vaishnavas.
但是呢我们进入中国让共产党成为 Vaishnava.
And then Prabhupada, they had just published Chinese Bhagavad Gita.
那么当时他们刚好呢在出版的中国的中文版的国家梵歌可能一手发布的
就是那
不是嘞七几年嘞那时候发布那些可能是香港台湾的奉献者估计。
So after Prabhupada, he gave this initiation to this devotee, his name is Yashomati Sutra.
Yeah, Yashomati. 难得呢。
Yashomati Sutra.
Yeah, yeah, Yashomati Sutra, 就是那个亚首我们说的亚首发布。香港的话翻译的早期的
翻译早期。
And then he said to him, you please speak, you please read something of this in Chinese.
所以Prabhupada当时呢就说了你读一段给我听啊中文啊。
So,
他翻的书。
So then Burijan said, even though in the Chinese is guttural, that was the word that I was looking up, that's how I found it, you know. And Prabhupada said, it sounded so sweet.
Guttural means kunafana.
Yeah, like, no, guttural means like, I don't know, more, I don't know, I can't quite understand, but it's a certain way of speaking. You know, it's just, I don't know how you can say it, maybe it's just a certain way of speaking.
然后 Burijan 就描述了，他说他们生活奉献者读那段话的时候虽然好像那个发音哦，有点好像有点怪怪的，但是呢，帕帕德说听起来很甜美。
他喜欢。Not stop smiling。
帕帕德好像止不住哦，在那里笑。
And he was so proud。
他非常自豪了哦，为这些
Chinese devotees。
就有一些中国奉献者加入到奉献者的团体里面去。
哇 ，So I thought that was interesting. Just 5 minutes ago, I read this.
我就五分钟前啊，就在读到这段书，就是会讲话不描述这个传记啊。就跟中国奉献者去印度那一段他就刚才读到了跟大家分享一下这样也还有一段就是那个亚首帕布好像是在日本的时候他不将国家梵歌吗加入帕帕德吗那时候 I told one story about 亚首在日本的时候他就把那国家梵歌给帕帕德看嘛帕帕德马上就狂喜啊他说一颗米熟了就是一锅米熟了就是有一个人能够读懂啊能够看懂这些书能够翻译出来那意味着将会有很多中国奉献者中国人会读懂这些东西会明白这个信息啊所以他当时是很狂喜的So Yashomati Prabhu in Japan you know he presented this Bhagavad Gita to Prabhupada the first time Prabhupada was ecstatic you know become ecstatic he said it's one rice is like it's well cookedAnd it means the whole pot, the rice, you know, is cooked.
Yes, yes. Yeah. He said something, I can't remember the end of, but he said something like that in the source.
Yeah.
He said, you know, he said, the whole nation has become successful because this one person has become Vaishnava.
他说只要一个奉献者成为，就因为一个人成为 Vaishnava, 那么整个民族呢就是成功了、就是说整个就能够呢发展起来的。
So you could imagine how happy Srila Prabhupada would be to see so many Vaishnavas in China now.
所以帕帕德如果见到现在中国很多奉献者，他实际上是非常高兴、非常喜悦的。
And becoming so serious about bhakti.
而且呢，就中国奉献者如果能够在灵修上方面的话呢，变得更加严肃啊，就真正去修，那么这些圣人更加喜悦。
And even they've taken shelter of Sadhguru.
就说呢，而且尤其是这些奉献者去托庇另外一个圣人。然后去追随那个使徒传系，那么你想象他有多高兴？
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Papa says great desires.
Oh yes. Yeah. Papa wanted to conquer the world. Okay. I was saying earlier to Yamuna that I wish I could communicate with you all. Mm-hmm.
之前呢，弟弟也跟我说，他希望呢，哈，能够跟大家交流，啊，有个交流。
You know, I would like to know how you all became devotees.
想知道你们怎么成为奉献者。
And how you met Guru Dev.
怎么遇到 Guru Dev?
Maybe sometime, you know, we can discuss.
可能在上课就是之间吧，可能也有些时间吧，可以跟大家聊一聊这些。In between the classes.
Because I know anyone who comes and takes shelter of Guru Dev.Anyone who has this qualification is an exalted personality.
因为任何人能够来到 Guru 面前去托庇 Guru 的话，他是一个了不起的灵魂，很特别的。
Right.
Hare Krishna.
Guru, just begin.
Yeah, just begin.
Itvam sharanam prapana brinde namaste charanarvindam Chinanda bhano sarananda suno para prema patri jatatama gatri Ganam lavitri jagatri jimatatri pavitri kriyano vapumi chukuchi Saptaham eva hasta chuta pankaje bringaya manam falumula kandare Samsevya manam hari matma vindake kopadana jim shirasana mami Dvaivashmi na jivami tvaya vina Iti vidyaya vadhi tvam nayamam shiranaputake I wanted to discuss with you, Rajmanda, please keep this in mind.
下午的课呢，我们讨论另外一本书，就是《八甲圣地朝拜经》这本书。
No, I didn't. I'm just going to say something else. First of all, before I do this, I wonder, who has been to Braj Mandal?
Who has been to Navadvipa Mandal?
Jayanti. So all the pastime places of Radha and Krishna and the cowherd boys and the gopis pastimes all over Braj.
那么在布拉吉整个地区啊。 就是说12个圣林吧，那么呢，所有呢 ，Radha Krishna 的逍遥时光啊，牧民童啊，Gopi们啊，他们的活动的地方。
Radha and Krishna performed their pastimes, and then when Mahaprabhu came, he also journeyed to all these places around Braj.
哦，那么在500多年前哈，Mahaprabhu呢，来到 Vrindavan 朝拜的时候，他也呢啊去呢走这些地方啊。
And after he left this world, the six Goswamis. Shiva Rupa Goswami, Shiva Sanatana Goswami, Shiva Raghunath Das Goswami, Shiva Goswami, Shiva Mohanbhatta Goswami, Shiva Raghunath Das Goswami. They all travel to all these places.
那么在呢，马可波时代啊，这个之后的话呢，六位 Goswami 的时间啊，包括 Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, 啊，Jiva Goswami, Gopalabhatta, 啊，还有 Raghunath Das Goswami. 那么他们呢，也在朝拜这些地方。And
they would do bhajan, really bhajan.
那么他们将在这地方呢，哈，从事呢真正的 bhajan。
And they would sit under different trees and perform their bhajan.
而且呢，在这个哦，温达文的不同的树啊下面去呢，哦，每天呢，哦，在不同的树下面去从事 bhajan 啊，灵性的专注了。Serving
the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
在呢，哦，这里面呢，去呢服务呢 Radha Krishna 的逍遥时光。Gurudev
says that they stayed under each tree for just a short period of time because under each tree, a different pastime of Radha and Krishna took place. So that pastime would manifest in their hearts, and they would engage in that pastime.
所以古鲁殿呢讲到了，他们在每一棵树下面停留的时间是比较短暂的，啊，然后呢，每一棵树呢，实际上它见证了不少不同逍遥时光。所以当在这些 Goswami 们呢，在那里呢从事 Bhajan 的时候呢，这逍遥时光向他们揭示出来，啊，所以他们呢在不同的啊树下面移动。
So in the Dham, there's three manifestations of Shri Vrindavan Dham.
我们讲了 Vrindavan Dham 的话呢，有三个展示。
There's one up here, Golok Vrindavan.
一个是就 Golok Vrindavan 啊，永恒的这个地方 Golok Vrindavan.
And Golok Vrindavan.
Yeah.
That's called. I can't write anything. I just realized there's no need because I can't even write anything.
It's okay.
Anyway, this is called Aprakat.
这个称为 Aprakat. 啊，这个圣地不展示的。
Prakat means manifest.
Prakat 的意思呢，就是展示啊，它是 Aprakat.
Sometimes we hear words that are similar, like Prakash.
Prakash.
Or Prachod, or do something that it means manifest. Prachodayat.
Prachodayat
means manifest.
就是展示出来，显示出来啊。 Prakash 也是一样的，它有这个词根呢，都是说显示出来、揭示出来的意思，为展示出来的。
So these pastimes are going on like in this map you can't all see. At the very top is Raja and Krishna's pastimes in the spiritual world.
所以呢，这个呢，在我们的宇宙图里面也有在上面部分啊，在灵性世界的啊，就是说呢，格罗克宾达文这个地方称为不展示的啊，这个夏尔时光啊部分。
And once in a day, Lord Brahma, that spiritual world manifests.In that effulgent spiritual world manifests in this material world.
那么在布拉玛的每一天里面，
啊、comes down.
那么这个呢，不展示的格罗克宾达文的话呢，那么它来到物质星球啊，进行一种展示了啊，就在物质世界的 Bhumi Vrindavan.
Yes, that's yes in the world land Vrindavan. This is Prakat.
这个称为呢 Prakat Vrindavan 啊，就是展示出来的 Vrindavan， 在地球上的 Vrindavan.
Now it's manifest.
所以呢，它现在的话呢，哈，属于展示状态。
Uppercut, we can't see it.
那么 uppercut 的话呢，在我们受条件限制的状态下，我们是看不见的。它对相对于我们来说，称为不展示的圣地。
But in Prakat Vrindavan, we can see, not we can see, it becomes manifest.
哦，所以呢，在 uppercut 在 Prakat Vrindavan 的话呢，它称为展示的 Vrindavan， 我们就能够呢参与这里面了。
In this Vrindavan, there's no Kamsa.
那么在那里的话没有 Kamsa，
there's no Jatila，
没有 Jatila，
or Kutila，
Kutila 啊，就是那里的婆婆。
There's no demons，
没有恶魔的。
Only an idea of them，
只有一个念头，在念头里面这些恶魔，他没有真正的恶魔，所以这些恶魔的话呢，他们不在 Goloka Vrindavan， 没有。
But in this realm, these demons manifest in forms as persons.
但是呢，在地球呢，展示的 Vrindavan 里面呢，这些恶魔呢，它有形体的，它展示出来。
And they manifest their pastimes.
Oh, no.
Krishna man performs pastimes with them.
Oh, Krishna 呢就跟他们有逍遥时光了啊，因为他们展示出来，他们现行了啊、yeah. 哦，所以呢 ，Krishna 跟这些恶魔呢也有一些逍遥时光。
波玛文丹文是什么意思？
就波玛文就是地球的文丹文，波玛就是地球的意思啊、哦。这个称为 Prakat， 就是说展示的文丹文也是一样的，就是在我们在地球星宿嘛。
Now.When in the material world, those pastimes only last for a couple of hundred, you know, 125 years.
那么这些逍遥时光的话呢，在地球上的话呢，婆罗门一天里面才展示120多年啊，就是上一个呢，库什显现的时候大概125年嘛。
And then they become unmanifest.
然后呢，就从我们视域中消失了，成为又不展示的。
That's the Vrindavan that we see.
那么现在我们就看到这个 Vrindavan， 三个。
We can't see this. See this.
我们看不见那个啊，就格罗克宾达文。
For this, we need a fully spiritual body.
因为你进入了格罗克宾达文，需要个全然的灵性身体，就是完全完美的人，你才能进去。
In this Vrindavan, some special qualification is there. The pastimes can be seen.
哦，那么进入呢，Prakat Vrindavan 的话，展示Vrindavan啊，就是会想刚好进行逍遥时光的时候你进去，那么这个需要很特别的资格。啊、也是要修行到一定程度，或是有特别因缘了，不一定是完美，但是呢，他才能够见到这个效果，是吧
？But in the other in this Vrindavan now it's called Drishyaman Prakash.
那么现在我们看到的 Vrindavan 呢，称为呢 Drishyaman Vrindavan.
Drishyaman. Prakash means it's Drishya means vision.
Drishya 的意思是啊，视域，就你看到的。
Prakash means manifested.
哦 ，Prakash 呢是展示的。
So it's manifested to our vision.
也就是说呢，这一个圣地的话呢，是给我们眼睛看到的。
And we go there on Braj Mandal Prakrama.
那么我们就在这个圣地啊，就是呢 ，Drishya Prakash，
Drishyaman，
Drishyaman Prakash， Vrindavan 朝拜。再能够向我们视域揭示的那个 Vrindavan， 就眼睛啊，展示的那个 Vrindavan 去朝拜。第三个。
So Srila Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur explains that.If we go to this Vrindavan without a spiritual guide, all we'll see is some trees、yeah. and some kuns and the Yamuna, and we'll just see everything with our external vision.
所以当时呢，巴蒂斯丹纳萨斯瓦里帕帕德，咱们师太公呢讲到了，他说如果你没有真正的指导，就灵性导师啊，真正的灵性导师去呢带着你去朝拜，你看到的不过是一些树、啊，一些小丛林啊，树林，还有呢河啊，亚穆纳河。
So it's essential that we go under a spiritual guide, a pure devotee.
所以呢，要呢朝拜的话呢，一定要在一个纯粹的奉献者的指导下去朝拜。
Because that pure devotee, he's seeing the real Vrindavan, the manifest, the unmanifest Vrindavan.
因为呢，这个真正的 Vaishnava 的话呢，奉献者呢，他能够看到呢，不展示的 Vrindavan。
And he can reveal that in our hearts.
因此呢，他有能力向我们揭示那个 Vrindavan 里面的所有东西。
So Srila Prabhupada says what he Thakur said that we have to fully surrender to the Vaishnava when we are on Parikrama.
所以呢，当时呢，巴蒂斯坦的萨斯瓦迪帕帕德讲到了，当你进行 Parikrama 的时候，朝拜的时候，你要完全呢皈依给呢这个呢 Vaishnava。
We have to throw out all of our ideas about how we want to do Parikrama.
那么应该把自己的概念呢抛下啊，就是我要怎么进行朝拜啊，这些概念呢抛下啊，那么跟随。
And let him arrange everything.
让他来安排，做出安排一切。
He said, if we turn our attention to the minutest sayings of the sadhu, then he will take us on the real Brajmandal Parikrama. If we turn our attention to his, every little saying, if we carefully watch everything he does.
但是如果你呢，在这个时候呢，哈，再仔细的呢去观看这个沙杜啊，这个真正的圣人，他所说的每句话啊，或是任何东西的所做的，那么你就呢，他能够集着他的仁慈，你进入真正的朝拜。
We may say,
这是里面的。
We may say, how is this possible? Gurudev doesn't come on Parikrama.
那么我们觉得哈，这怎么可能呢哈？我们 Gurudev 也不出来跟我们一起朝拜啊。有时候哈，就极少情况出来啊。
So we have to understand it's Gurudev's desire that we do this Parikrama.
但是呢，我们要明白的话呢，我们进行这个 Parikrama 朝拜的话是 Gurudev 的愿望，那是他的愿望。
And simply by trying to fulfill this desire of Gurudev's for us.、
Yeah.
We will get the same result.
那么呢，我们只是藉由呢哈去实现呢 Gurudev 对我们存在的这个愿望啊，他对我们寄予的一个愿望，那么我们就能得到这个结果，因为这个是他的愿望，要我们去朝拜。
Srila Gurudev quotes, there's a famous benediction given by Narad Muni that anyone who goes on Brajmandal Parikrama and hears the pastimes.At the holy places, Krishna Prema will one day manifest in his heart.
那么 Gurudev 提到了哈，这个 Narada Muni 得到 Krishna 一个特别的祝福了啊。他说，如果在呢朝拜的地方，任何人聆听到啊关于呢圣地的这些荣耀啊等等了，那么他呢就能够有一天能够得到了 Krishna Prema.
And also, if he touches the dust of those places, those pastimes, that Krishna Prema will also manifest in his heart.
还有呢哈，他去触碰呢这些圣地的尘土。啊、那么有一天的话呢，这个 Krishna Prem 的话呢，也会在他心中啊展示了。
So in Golok Vrindavan, we always hear that Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan, the supreme personality of God.
那么我们总是听到呢哈，有一个呢说法呢 ，Krishna 称为呢 Swayam Bhagavan， 与原始的性格神手。
But in Vrindavan, he does not play the role of God.
但是呢，在 Vrindavan 我们知道他并不是扮演自尊性格神手这个角色的，没有。
He doesn't work like.
啊，也就是他不是这样运作的。
Instead, he just enjoys.
他享受这个啊，在 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光。
And it said that he drowns in oceans of love and affection.
也就是说，他沉溺在呢哈这些人对他的这个爱的汪洋大海之中。
So it's the conception of the Rupa Nuga Vaishnavas or the Gaudiya Vaishnavas to attain the Lord Vrindavan.This is our destination.
那么呢，对于 Rupa Nuga 的 Vaishnava 哈，就追寻 Rupa Goswami 传系的这些 Vaishnava 呢，我们的目标呢是到达呢 Golok Vrindavan.
So the six Goswamis they would do Parikrama of Vrindavan.
所以呢，六 Goswami 呢，他们也进行了 Vrindavan 的这个绕拜啊，这个朝拜。
And then Raghava Pandit took Narottam Das Thakur and Srinivas Acharya on Brajmandal Parikrama.
那么Raghava.
Raghava Pandit.
Raghava Pandit, 啊，其中一个后期的啊 ，Vaishnava 了，他呢带领呢 Narottam Das Thakur， 嗯，什么呢？
Srinivas Acharya.
啊 ，Srinivas Acharya 的话呢，也进行了朝拜啊，就六波双明之后的啊这个时代。
And this was arranged by Srila Jiva Goswami himself. He said, "I need you. I would like you to take them on."
那么这是 Jiva Goswami 安排的啊，他是六波双明最年轻的一位了，他安排呢这个呢Raghava.
Raghava
Pandit 啊，去呢，就是带他们去朝拜。
Then in 1932, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, he began a Brajmandal Parikrama.
所以在1932年的时候呢，哈，这个呢，就是 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada 的话呢，才开始呢，这个呢，绕拜啊，就组织了这些人去朝拜，步行朝拜。
And in, I think it was 10 years later, our Param Gurudev also began Prajnanda Parikrama.
哦，那么在十年之后吧，哦，就四十年代了。那么我们师公呢，哦，就是呢，他来组织，哦，那时候就是太空已经隐寂了，哦，那么他来组织的这个呢，所办。
With our Gurudev.Our Gurudev would accompany him, our Param Gurudev's.
那么当时的 Gurudev 呢，也就在其中了，加入其中。
Gurudev's service was he was in charge of constructing the tents for accommodation.
那么 Gurudev 然后那时候也负责就是呢，包括呢给这些朝拜者搭建这个帐篷啊，搭一些棚啊，要做这些工准备工作的。
Yes, that was his special service.
这是他的其中一个服务。
Looking after the guests, making everyone.
也就是说呢，去照顾呢这些来客了，就是一些朝拜的人然后呢让大家呢都就是说很满意的。
Gurudev became known as Bhaktabandhu, friend of the Vaishnavas.
所以当时 Gurudev 有一个称号他们给他一个称号叫 Bhaktabandhu, 就是奉献者的朋友。
So
Bhaktabandhu.
So Gurudev has done this parikrama since 1954.
He organized.
56. He's been doing Braj Mandal parikrama for 56 years.
那么是一九五几年吧，五四年他开始的。早期他没有参加，四几年那么一九五几年呢，他开始加入，然后呢，这么多年他都进行了这个组织和呢朝拜的工作。
And you know, up until 10 years ago, or even 6, 7 years ago, he would personally.Go everywhere with us.
就是六七年吧，之前吧，零三年那样子他都还能带队的。
I remember once we had to go for a very long walk at the end of the day, and Gurudev, he walked with us the whole way, and he said, "I was not going to come, but I could see you were all tired, and I wanted to give you energy." So for that.
有一次的话呢，他们的这个路线很长的那么 Gurudev 说了，他本来。不想来的但是呢，看到你们很累啊，想给大家一点能量，所以他也来了那么大家走了很长一个路那天的路线非常长。
So the first of this, just like there are 10 offenses to the holy name, there are 10 offenses to the dham.
那么我们讲到有对圣名呢有十项的冒犯，实际上对 dham 这个圣地的话呢也有十项的冒犯。
And the very first offense is to disrespect the guru who reveals the holy dham in the heart.
那么第一个呢，就是说呢，去不恭敬这个向你在内心向你揭示圣地的这个guru你不恭敬他，你不尊敬他。
So he's the one who's really doing Brajmandal.
因为呢，只有他是真正进行 Braj 朝拜的人。
We're not really. We're just like wandering.
我们没有在朝拜我们是在那里呢走来走去，像个盲人摸象一样。
We have where our hearts are full of selfish desires.
因为我们心里面很多自私的欲望
And we all know that in Vrindavan, Golok Vrindavan, no one has any selfish desires.
我们也知道在 Golok Vrindavan 呢，没有人有这种自私的欲望。
So how is it possible for us to see?
所以呢，我们怎么可能见到呢
？One night, oh sorry, one day. What's that? I.
So you don't want to see?
Don't want to see.
So even though Vrindavan is a place.It's an actual location. It's actually a plane of consciousness.
那么 Vrindavan 呢？现在我们是看到它是一个地方，一个地点。但是实际上呢，它是一个知觉层面。就你到达某个知觉层面的话呢，你能进入。
对。
Yeah. All right.So I'm just going to draw a real rough map of Say this is a road actually. This is the way down. This is how Brajmandala looks on the map.
这是在地图上哈 ，Braja 这个地方大致的一个。
In reality, Braj Mandala is a 108 petal lotus.
那么真正来说呢，哈 ，Braj 这个地方呢是108片的哈，这个花瓣的这个莲花。
And it can't be measured.
这个是不能够被量夺的，只是这样说啊，但是它是不可测夺的，就没有物质能够测量它的。
But out of mercy, it manifests in this world.
但是是出于仁慈的话呢，哈，圣地的话呢，展示在这个世界。
So this is the entire Braj Mandala. This is the Yamuna River.
哦，那么蓝色那个是雅穆纳河哦。
Okay. So about here, this is Vrindavan. About there.
Vrindavan 在这个位置啊、哦，那是公路啊、哦，黑的那个是公路。
This is Govardhan.
戈瓦丹山在公路另外一边，我们都知道。
There's Vashana here.
Vashana 啊、哦，在这个位置。
Nandagram is there.
Nandagram.
Javat is there.
Javat 啊、哦，他们三个地方。
And there are 12 major forests.
那么我们知道呢 ，Braja 这个地方呢，总共有12个主要的森林。
They start, I won't write them, but Badra,
Bajavan,
Bandiravan,
Bandiravan,
Bale,
Balevan,
Loha,
Lohavan,
Madhu,
Madhuvan,
Kumud,
Kumudvan,
Bakula,
Bakulavan,
Kamyavan, Kadira,
Kadiravan.
These are the 12 forests.
就总共了12个森林。
So, Mathura is about here.
Mathura 在这个位置。
So I once went to Gurudev with a question that I was a bit confused
by. 那么当时我就有一个问题，我问的 Gurudev 就是有点迷惑了。
Because we can see here is a map of Braj Mandala.
因为我们看到呢 ，Braj Mandala 的地图呢是这么大的。
But we can see Mathura is in it.
那么看到呢 ，Mathura 也在里面。
So I asked him, we hear that Krishna leaves Vrindavan and goes to Mathura.
那么我们听到了啊，不想离开 Vrindavan 之后呢，他去掉了 Mathura。
Actually, in this, before that map I drew of Golok Vrindavan in the spiritual sky, Krishna never leaves to go to Mathura.
哦，但是呢，在 Golok Vrindavan 的话呢 ，Krishna 呢从来不离开它。
That only happens in this Braj.
这是在呢展示的 Braj 啊、哦，这个发生的逍遥时光呢，展示的逍遥时光里面，他有时会离开某个地方，去到另外一个地方。
So we hear that Krishna leaves Vrindavan and goes to Mathura, but how can that be when we can see that Mathura is in Braj Mandala?
哦，那么呢，我们说了啊，他离开啊 Mathura Vrindavan 呢，去掉了 Mathura， 那怎么可能呢？啊，因为 Mathura 呢，看起来他在这个 Braj 的这个大的地图里面。
Do you understand?
明不明白？就为什么说他离开了？他在地图里面呢 ，Mathura。
You got it?
Yeah.
明白。
So Gurudev said, he said it's just like.At night, we look up into the sky, and we see so many stars in the sky.
如你讲到了，就像在晚上你看这个天空啊，有很多啊、哦、这个星星啊。
From down on the ground, it looks as if the sky is flat.
那么在地上看天空呢，好像是平板，啊、哦，平板上啊、哦、有很多星星。
But actually, some stars are closer, and some are very, very, very far.
但是的话呢，实际上有的星星跟我们比较近，有的很远很远。
So he said it's like this. Mathura looks as if it's in Braj.
所以呢，同样的 ，Mathura 从我们的角度看起来好像跟 Vrindavan 很近。
But actually, it's another plane of consciousness.
实际上是另外一个层面的知觉。
Mathura is there and Braj is.
也就是说呢 ，Mathura 在这个位置啊、哦，这个呢 ，Braj 呢在更高的一个知觉层面。我们这样看的好像在天空的星星啊，有的离得近，离得远。但是你看好像是个平板形嘛，没有什么区别，好像都在里面。
More high is Radhakund.
哦，当然呢，比呢哈、哦、这个温达文更高的是拉达坤的知觉，啊、哦，拉达坤那里。
So, a proof that we can see how enthusiastic Gurudev is for Braj Mandala.
Gurudev's
own enthusiasm.
啊，那么我们看到了在朝拜中哈、哦、Gurudev 的这种热情、哦、
And we can see that. And we can see that.He is a perfect example of surrender to his Gurudev.
那么他也是一个完美的榜样了，皈依孤鲁的一个完美榜样。
So we can understand that this is the natural fruit of full surrender to one's Gurudev.
那么这是一个呢哈对孤鲁完整的啊去呢皈依自己的一个呢自然的结果。
Automatically, the Dharma is manifesting.
也就是说呢，自动的呢，这个整个圣地呢，啊，向他呢展示了。
So in this Golok Vrindavan, as we just said, Krishna is not the supreme personality of Godhead.
那么我们讲到在 Golok Vrindavan 呢 ，Krishna 并非呢哈这个自尊性格神兽。
He's very naughty boy.
哦，而是一个呢很调皮的孩子。